I'm going to show you three ways to edit slow motion footage in Premiere Pro. You'll learn how to correctly interpret slow motion footage. I will show you how to set up the speed of a video and also how to make a speed ramp, which is a bit more complex, but you will enjoy it, so keep watching. Hey, I'm Chris, welcome back to iStalker. If this is your first time here and you want to learn how to edit photos, videos, or you want to see some tech stuff, make sure you hit the subscribe and the bell notification so you won't miss anything. And now let's play with some slow motion. So with Premiere Pro opened on my screen, I'm going to import some footage here. I will just drag and drop a movie into my project panel. This was shot at 120 frames per second with the GoPro 4 Black. And let's create a new sequence. I will choose the 1080p 24 frames per second sequence, which in fact is 23.976 frames per second. That's the setting used in cinematography, and I use it a lot lately on my videos. And I have one question for you guys. What frame rate do you enjoy the most and why? Is it 24 frames per second, 30, 60, 120, 180? It's up to you. Leave your comments below. Good, so let's recap. I have a new sequence at 24 frames per second and a video file at 120 frames per second. If I drag the video into the timeline, it will play at the original speed and not in slow motion as you may expect. Let me show you. So I hit the space bar and the video starts playing at normal speed. So what should I do to slow it down? Well, I will delete the video from the timeline, then I'm gonna right click on the video file in the project panel, go to modify, and interpret footage. Right now the sequence is using the frame rate from the file, which is almost 120 frames per second, but I will choose assume this frame rate and write in 23.976 and then hit OK. So if I double click this file now, it will show up in a preview mode, and if I hit play, the video is playing in slow motion. I can create a mark for the endpoint by pressing I on the keyboard and then create an out point by pressing O. If I drag this into the timeline, you can see that Premiere will only add the selected part of the video. And again, if I hit play, the video is running in slow motion. Here's another way to slow down footage in Premiere Pro. Let's do this one, and then I will show you my favorite way to slow down footage with the speed ramp method. I created the same sequence at 24 frames per second. I dragged in the same file and I created the in and out points. So let's drag this video into the timeline, and instead of interpreting the footage, I right click and select speed duration. Now, to know exactly what percentage should you use here, you need to do some simple math. You take the frame rate of the sequence, in my case is 24 frames per second. You multiply it by 100, and the result must be divided by the frame rate of the video file, which in my case is 120 frames per second. The result is 20. So I need to enter 20% here, hit OK, and if I play the video now, that's the optimal slow motion. If you have, for example, a 60 frames per second video file, then the optimal speed for slow motion should be 40%. And now I will show you the third method for slow motion called speed ramp, which is my favorite. First, make sure you push this line up until you will see the keyframe buttons, these two arrows or triangles, and this circle. And then right click on this FX icon, choose time remapping, and then choose speed. You will see a straight line here, which basically tells you that the video is playing at 100% of its speed. Then you search for a point where you want to start the slow motion. You add a keyframe from here and you'll see that the marker is present now. Now I choose a point where my slow motion will stop. For example, here, and I add another keyframe. And then I will just drag this line down to 20%. And this means that this segment will play in slow motion. If I hit play, you can see that the movie starts at normal speed, then it slows down, and then it comes back to normal speed. But you can make it even smoother than this. If I split these two handles, the transition will be much smoother than before, and I will do the same for the out point as well. So now, if I hit play, you can see that the movie slows down in a more pleasant way for the eyes. This is the speed ramp method. If you want to export this into a final movie, just press Ctrl plus M. I usually choose H.264 as a codec, and as a preset, I will choose the 1080p 23.976 frames per second. The frame rate when exporting should be the same like the frame rate of the sequence that you created in the beginning. Then you click on Export, and Premiere Pro will create your final movie. So that's it, guys. Press the like button if you enjoyed this video, and make sure you click on the circle icon to subscribe if you want to see more Adobe tutorials or tech videos. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram @iStalker. I'm Chris. Catch you in the next one.